For the third time in a week, Julia Gillard has taken a financial baseball bat to her much-hyped working families. Some are even calling it a betrayal. First, she hiked up the Medicare levy, reneged on better family benefits, and now promised income tax cuts are off. Ten's National Affairs editor Paul Bongiorno joins us now from Canberra. And Paul, this is starting to look like kamikaze politics.
Well, Sandra, I'm not sure that Julia Gillard is a willing dive bomber, but almost daily we're seeing the strategy behind her budget and the government's budget seeming to unravel. The Prime Minister says it's a time for difficult decisions. Clearly, she'll be hoping the voters cut her some slack. The opposition certainly isn't.
A mostly warm welcome for the Prime Minister at a Brisbane high school, but there was at least one protesting voice. A sandwich was thrown, missed its mark, and left Ms Gillard unfazed.
A bit of hijinks.
Not so easy to dismiss the junking of carbon tax compensation slated for 2015. Last year's budget forecasts of the revenue, based on the price, too optimistic.
This is a recognition that the carbon price is going to be less.
Another day, another broken promise. Legislated tax cuts under Julia Gillard are to be dumped.
Our European-linked carbon scheme means the budget this year will forecast a price around $15 a tonne, about half last year's forecast. So the tax cuts are on ice.
They'll be deferred until such time as the carbon price exceeds $25.40, whenever that may be.
If you couldn't trust last year's budget, why should you trust this year's budget?
The government says compensation already given to families, pensioners and the low paid remains untouched. But Labor says Tony Abbott will raise taxes for 7 million workers with his carbon plans.
There was more agreement on disability care. Queensland now on board, meaning 90% of Australians will be covered.
I'm absolutely thrilled and delighted to be here with the Prime Minister. This is a historic moment.
WA and the Northern Territory still holding out, but at least in Perth, the door hasn't been slammed shut. Negotiations continue.
I think we've had a few of those.
And the Prime Minister says legislation to raise the Medicare levy to help pay for the disability care system will be introduced into Parliament as early as next week.
OK, thank you. Paul Bongiorno there.